Hello everyone, welcome back to biology class. Today in this video we will study about thyroid gland, parathyroid gland and the thymus gland. Pituitary gland, it is a master gland which control other endocrine glands, in which a thyroid gland, it is one of the gland which is under the control of pituitary gland. Thyroid gland, it is the largest endocrine gland. It is situated in front of the trachea, just below the larynx. You know, the larynx, it is a sound box, and below that a tracheal tube is present through which the air is entering into the lungs. In anteriormost part of the trachea, thyroid gland is present. Thyroid gland has two lobes. These are the secretory lobes, the right and the left lobe, present on either side of trachea. Both the lobes, they are connected by non-secretory band, and this band, it is called as isthmus. Non-secretory means here the secretion, it is not coming from this region of the thyroid gland, and that's why isthmus, it is called as a non-secretory band. Thyroid gland, in which the follicles, they are present, which are the secretory structure. Let us see what is the follicle. Let us study about cross section of the thyroid gland or the transverse section of the thyroid gland. Thyroid gland, in which follicles are present. Follicles means here the cells, they are arranged in the form of the ring. In the ring, cuboidal epithelial cells are present. These cells are cube shaped. They are secretory structure. They secrete the secretion. It is present in the form of hormone. The hormones, they are collected inside the follicle. Inside the follicle, a cavity is present. The cavity, it is called as a follicular cavity. This cavity, in which here the colloid, which is the inactive form of the hormone, it is stored temporarily. Just outside the follicle, some more cells are present. Those cells, they are called as parafollicular cells. Look at the figure, you can find this parafollicular cell, they are white in structure and they are present just outside the follicle cells. So the position of this parafollicular cell, or these cells, they are also termed as the C cells. They are just outside the follicle cells, and these cells, they are also responsible to secrete the hormone. It is a calcitonin. Let us study about the physiology of thyroid gland. Thyroid gland, it is functioning under the control of pituitary gland. Pituitary gland, it gives the hormone TSH, that is thyroid stimulating hormone. This stimulating hormone, when it reaches to the thyroid gland, along with the blood, thyroid gland get excited and the functioning of the thyroid gland, it start. Thyroid gland secrete thyroxine, or it is called as the tetraiodothyronine. These are the hormones, they are also termed as T3 and the T4 hormones. They are secreted in presence of TSH. Let's see how the thyroxine, it is synthesized in thyroid gland. Student, you know there are the different types of the amino acids. Tyrosine is one of the amino acid. Tyrosine, when it is combined with the iodine molecule, it gives the monoiodothyronine. It is also termed as T1, which is the first step in the formation of thyroxine. When two molecules of monoiodothyronine, when it is combined together, it gives diiodothyronine. It is also termed T2. When T2, it is combined with T1, it gives T3, that is the triiodothyronine. In triiodothyronine, one molecule of monoiodothyronine thyronine is present and the one molecule of diiodothyronine is present. The tetraiodothyronine, in which four molecules of iodines are present, and this tetraiodothyronine, it is produced by the combination of T1 and T3 molecule. T1, it is a monoiodothyronine. When it is combined with triiodothyronine, it gives the T4, that is the tetraiodothyronine. The T3 and the T4, these are the two active form of thyroxine. Out of that, 3-3, it is a more active compared to T4. Now we'll study about the functions of thyroxine. Thyroxine hormone, it helps to regulate BMR of the body. BMR means basal metabolic rate, which control protein metabolism, carbohydrate metabolism, and fat metabolism. The second function of thyroxine is to regulate the metabolism of protein synthesis. As it controls the protein synthesis, it also controls the growth of the tissue. You know, for the growth of the tissue, a different types of the proteins are required. So these proteins are synthesized in presence of thyroxine. Thyroxine also play a very important role in thermoregulation. Thermo means the temperature. Here the body temperature, it is regulated in presence of thyroxine by increasing the heat production in the body. It also increases the action of neurotransmitter. We know the neurotransmitter, these are the substances secreted by the nerve cells. These are the chemical substances secreted by the nerve cell, which help to transmit the impulse from nerve cell to nerve cell. The neurotransmitter adrenaline and the noradrenaline, they are active in presence of the thyroxine. The next function is to maintain the water and the electrolyte balance. So with the help of this, the blood volume, it is under the control. And last one, it also controls the reproductive cycle in female. So the reproductive cycle in case of the female, these reproductive organs, they are also under control of thyroxine. Let us see what are the disorders are produced if thyroid gland, if it is not functioning normally. If a thyroxine level, it is increased than the normal level, because of the hyperactivity of thyroid gland, a condition it is produced, it is called as a hyperthyroidism. The another condition which is produced, which is also the disorder, it is called hypothyroidism. Here the hypo indicates the low level. Here the thyroxine level in the blood, it is a low. Yes. So the condition, it is called as a hypothyroidism. So under the hypothyroidism, we have to study two more disorders, that is the cretinism and the myxedema. So these two conditions, it is present under what? Hypothyroidism. And under the hyperthyroidism, a disorder which comes, it is called Graves' disease. Now let us see about the Graves' disease, which is the disorder because of hypersecretion of thyroxine. This disorder, it is also called as a exophthalmic goiter. Exo indicates outside. Ophthalmic indicates the eye. Here, eyeballs, its size, it is increased and it is not easily fit into the orbit. And that's why they comes out and the condition is formed protruding eyeballs. So this protruding eyeballs, we can easily see in this picture. This is the picture of what the Graves' disease person. Okay, its eyeball size is increased. Because of the hypersecretion of thyroxine, the BMR rate is also increased. Body gain weight. heartbeat rate increase, blood pressure increase, body temperature, it is also high, nervousness, tremors in the finger, and eyelid, it get retracted. Retracted means eyelid remains at high level, or lower eye remains below the colored part or the iris. Next disorder, it is a cretinism, which is because of under secretion of thyroid gland. The condition is produced is the cretinism. Cretinism, it is found in the children's. So in the early development, when the thyroxine level is less, this condition is produced. In this condition, the basal metabolic rate, it is reduced. It also affects on the growth, and that's why such children's, they are short, their skeleton fail to grow, overall growth, it is very slow, they are mentally retarded because the brain development is also affected. Skin is dry, they have thick tongue, they are lethargic, they are not active, they have the constipation problem, and they have delayed puberty because the reproductive organs development is also affected, and that's why the sex hormone secretion in their body, it is very less, and that's why maturation of the reproductive organ, it is a delayed, and we say that it is a delayed puberty. The next disorder, it is a myxedema. It is the condition which is formed in the adulthood when thyroid gland, it failed to secrete sufficient quantity of thyroxine. Because of this, the different symptoms it is seen. Here, edema means the swelling. Edema or the swelling, it is seen all over the body. Prominently, it is seen on the face and below the eyeball. It is termed as periorbital edema. So in the picture, we can see the periorbital edema, that is what the swelling, which is seen just below the eyeballs. You can also find here the puffiness of the skin. Puffiness means the swelling, and the skin becomes what? A dry. Such persons, their body temperature is low. Their sexual development, it is also what? Slow. They have difficulty in the breathing also. Their tongue and the lower legs, on which also swelling it is seen. In case of pregnant female, if there is a deficiency of the thyroxine is there, because of low level of thyroxine, the developing baby, its growth and the maturation is get affected. So this is what about the myxedema. Simple goiter, it is the condition which is formed because of deficiency of iodine in the diet. As iodine, it is in deficient quantity, the thyroxine formation, it is reduced. In that condition, thyroid gland, it increase its size. Though the size of the thyroid gland, it is increased, the secretion of thyroxine, it is not increased. So increased mass of this thyroid gland, it can be easily seen in the form of the bulge. Look at the figure. We can see here this bulge or the increased mass of the thyroid gland in front of the neck. So we can easily mark this sign, and we can easily identify the person who is having simple goiter. If the diet is changed, in the diet the extra iodine if it is increased. This condition can be changed. The person will become a normal one. As the iodine concentration, it is increased in the diet, the thyroid gland, it will be a normal one and it will start producing a normal level of thyroxine. So the simple goiter condition can be changed by change of a diet. Generally, this condition, it is found very common in the hilly region than the population which is living near the seashore. As you know, in the hilly region, they are far away from the seashore. In their diet, the seafood is very less. The seafood have more iodine. And that's why here, the people, those who are living at hilly region, they have generally the deficiency of iodine. And that's why in this region, there the cases of simple goiter, it is more compared to other region. This can be achieved by addition of iodine with the salt. We know in every food atom, we are adding the salt. So along with the salt, if this iodine is get added, there is a no chance of simple goiter. And that's why in our market nowadays, here the salt is available in the form of iodized form, just to what control the simple goiter. Student, we have studied in the cross section of thyroid gland, outside the follicular cell, a para follicular cells are present, or these are also called C cells. The C cells, they are responsible for the secretion of hormone calcitonin. Let's see what is the role of calcitonin. Student, look at the figure. With the help of this, we will study the role of calcitonin. Calcitonin plays a very important role to decrease the calcium level in the plasma. We know this, the calcium, it is a very important element which is get absorbed in the bone in presence of the calcitonin. If the level of calcitonin is the high, the absorption of the calcium from blood to the bone, it is increased. At the same time, from the bone, the calcium release, it is stopped. And that's why here in the blood, the calcium level, it is decreased. So calcitonin, it is the hormone, it lowers the calcium level in the blood and it increases the calcium level in the bone. Next, endocrine gland, it is a parathyroid gland. Parathyroid gland, it is situated on posterior surface of thyroid gland. They have two pairs. The first pair, which is the uppermost one, it is called superior parathyroid gland, and the lower pair of parathyroid gland, it is the inferior parathyroid gland pair. So here, one is the upper side, superior, one is lower side, it is the inferior. They secrete peptide hormone called parathormone, or in short, it is called PTH. Parathormone play a very important role to maintain the calcium and the phosphorus balance in blood as well as tissue. Student, with the help of this figure, we will study the role of parathormone. We know parathormone, it is a hormone which is coming from the parathyroid gland, and it play important role in increase of calcium in the plasma. So how this increase of the calcium in plasma, it is seen? It is by four ways. The first way is what? Here, from the blood, calcium, it is not going to be absorbed in the bone. So increased level of parathormone, it reduces the absorption of calcium from blood to bone. Second way, here from the bone, calcium release it start. So from the bone, you know, the bone is a storage of the calcium. From the bones, the calcium get released. When the calcium get released, when there is an increase of parathormone is there. The third way of calcium increase is what? To decrease the excretion of calcium through the urine. So here, calcium ions, they are not, their excretion, it is a excretion, it is a decreased. So in the urine, the calcium ion present, it is very less. And the fourth way, here the calcium ions, it get absorbed from the digestive tract. So from the digestive system, calcium is coming into the blood by the absorption process. As a excretion process in which the calcium ion excretion, it is less. So the calcium ion, it will be more in the blood. Yes. So all these four ways, they are responsible for to increase the calcium level in the plasma. So here parathormone, it play important role in increase of what, calcium ions concentration in the blood, which is just opposite to the function of calcitonin. We know that calcitonin, it is responsible to decrease of what, the calcium level in the plasma. So both the hormones, they are maintaining our calcium level in the blood. They are playing their role antagonistically. Parathyroid gland, if it is not functioning normally, then the disorder is produced. Those disorders, it is because of hyper secretion of parathormone and under secretion of the parathormones. So let us study about these disorders. Parathyroid tetany, this is the disorder, it is produced because of hyposecretion of parathyroid hormone. As the hormone level is low, the calcium level in the blood is also reduced. Because of low level of calcium, excitability of the nerves, it is increased. And it causes muscle twitch and the spasm. The spasm, it is a condition in which sudden involuntary contraction of muscle, it is seen. This contraction, it is a temporary, maybe for a second or minutes, or it lasts for a longer period. But it is the temporary one. Osteoporosis, it is the condition which is produced because of hypersecretion of parathyroid hormone. Osteo means the bone. Porosis means the formation of porous structure or the spongy structure. This is all because of more absorption of the calcium from the bones. And that's why bones becomes soft. They get easily bent and get easily fractured. This is the condition generally it is seen during the menopause in case of females. The menopause, it is a condition in which the female reproductive cycle, it stops. Next endocrine gland, it is the thymus gland. It is located in the upper part of the thorax. Student, look at the figure. On ventral side of the heart, the thymus gland is present. It is soft, it is pinkish, and it is a bilobed mass. This gland, it is a temporary gland. In old age, its size, it is reduced. This gland is responsible for secretion of the hormone thymosin. Thymosin play very important role in the development of immune system and the maturation of T lymphocyte. It also promote the formation of antibodies. These are the soldier cells. They are produced when antigen it is present in our body. This all we are learn in human immunity chapter. Hope you understood today's topic. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned for further updates.